Mia arranged her stickers in an array. Write a repeated addition statement to show how many stickers she has in all.
Hey, mathematicians. Looks like we've got another quest to solve. And this one's got something called an array. What's an array? We haven't worked with them before, but we do know a few ways to find a total amount. So let's start there. Mia's been collecting lots of cool things she wants to find the total of. She's gathered a few of her collections so we can practice finding totals before solving our math quest, like these buttons. How can we find the total? Exactly, we can count them. Okay, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wait, did I already count that one? Let me start over. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What's that? I skipped one? Okay. I've got it this time. I'll start counting from this side instead. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Ah, you're right, Mia. This is taking a while. There has to be a quicker way to count these buttons. Whoa, that looks way more organized. Mia lined up the buttons in rows that go from side to side and columns that go up and down. Each row is the same size and length, and so is each column. So that must mean there's an equal number of buttons in each row and in each column. When objects are arranged in equal rows and equal columns, like this one, it's called an array. You've probably seen arrays before. They're all around us. Eggs in a carton, muffins in a tin, and crayons in their box are all organized in arrays. Let's try counting the buttons in an array by rows to see if it's faster. How many buttons are in the first row? 1, 2, 3, 4. Right. And if there are 4 in the first row, how many buttons are in the second and third rows? 4. Yep. Because all the rows are equal. Okay, so we've got 3 rows of 4. What can we do with all those 4s to get the total? That's it. We can add them all together. Using repeated addition. Repeated addition is adding the same number over and over again to get a sum. It's the same as adding multiple add-ins together like we did in our first math quest of Unit 9, only this time, all the add-ins are the same number. Let's try grouping the numbers and adding vertically. If we add 4 plus 4, that equals 8 plus 4 more is how many? 12. That's 12 total buttons in the array. Wow, that was definitely faster than counting by ones. What if we wanted to find the total amount of buttons by adding up the columns instead? Do you think our answer would be the same? Let's check. How many buttons are in the first column? 3, right. So that means all the columns have 3 buttons. There are 4 columns here, so we add 3 4 times. First, we add 3 plus 3, which is 6. Yes. Plus 3 more is 9, plus another 3. How many is that? 12 buttons in all. 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 equals 12. Hey, we got the same sum both ways by adding the number of objects in each row or each column. If both sums match, our repeated addition is correct. You mean there's another way to check our work? Oh, by skip counting. After finding the total, we can skip count all the rows or columns. If the totals match, our answer is correct. Try it with me. Mia added the rows in this array. 5 plus 5 plus 5 equals 15. Since there are 5 cupcakes in each row, we can skip count by 5s to check. 5, 10, 15. The totals match. Nice work, Mia. All right, it's that time again. We'll need to use everything we learned today to solve our math quest. Grab your pencil and let's get started. Mia arranged her stickers in an array. Write a repeated addition statement to show how many stickers she has in all. Remember, you can use rows or columns to write a repeated addition statement. Pause here to solve this problem on your math quest. Then, check your work with skip counting and we'll compare our answers. What did you get? Whether you used rows or columns to add, our sums should be the same. To find the total using rows, that's 4 stickers in each row and 5 rows in all. So we add 4 5 times. 4 plus 4 equals 8. Plus 4 more is 12. Adding down the ones place, we get 10. We regroup and add the tens. 1 plus 1 is 2. So that's 20 stickers in Mia's array, or 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4 equals 20. If you chose to use columns, we can count 5 stickers in every column and 4 columns total. That's 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5, which is also 20. And if we skip count the columns, 5, 10, 15, 20 again. Excellent job, problem solvers. We checked our work 2 different ways and got the same answer each time. I'm feeling super confident that we're correct. Time to input. Write our final answer on your math quest while I input our answer. Way to go! We solved another math quest and learned how to use repeated addition to count objects in an array. Remember, every problem has a solution, and we've got the skills to solve it. See you next time! Hey, hey.